We've been foetal aging at Valera Vale since 1981. We used to do all manual preg testing. We've now moved on to using the scanner for most of it. Both have their advantages. In our hands, the scanner gives us more accurate aging of the fetus, and we can pick them up a fair bit earlier than we can manually. We initially started doing the foetal aging to give us a histogram of the calving pattern, which gives us a report card on how well we manage the joining. Since then, we only have a 13-week joining period, but we've used it to split into the first half and second half on numbers more than weeks, so that we can avoid having big calves at branding or really little calves at branding. Our seasons are reliably unreliable here. Foetal aging allows us to concentrate the calving period, which then allows us to do targeted supplementation to the cows that need it most. It also allows us to do targeted early weaning.
Foetal aging is a tool used to predict the calving distribution over the forthcoming 7 to 8 months. It identifies the stage of pregnancy your individual female is at, rather than just pregnant or empty itself. And although it does identify the stage of pregnancy your females are at, it is not a 100% guarantee of projected calving date, as a normal gestation length varies by at least a month. One of the benefits of ranking your cows by optimum calving time is segregation. So you're able to segregate your cows of similar pregnancy stages together, which allows for similar calves of similar ages. This allows for targeted management such as branding and weaning.
Our targeted early weaning in extreme dry conditions, we've done it down to 1 month of age on specially formulated feeds that are designed for baby dairy calves. This saves us the cow, the calf, and potentially next year's pregnancy as well. Body condition score and weight at our time of joining is one of the most critical factors in getting the cow back in calf. Targeted weaning is very critical to our next year's joining period, in that we can increase the cow's body condition score at the time of joining, and it also decreases our breeder mortality in extreme drought conditions. Foetal aging can give us information on our joining period and indicate any problems that can be fixed for next year. This can flag problems in our joining period, such as the heifers taking longer to get in calf, in which case we would be looking for infectious processes such as Vibrio, or having to review our body condition score and our weights at the start of the joining period. It can also indicate a bull failure if we've had good fertility initially, but then subsequent cycles the fertility has dropped off. In poor seasonal conditions, we can wean calves a lot earlier. If we didn't foetal age and didn't segregate, then we would be either having to delay our weaning until the youngest of the calves were old enough to handle coming in, or we would be knocking these baby calves around for no reason when we can't wean.
Segregating cows into calving groups is also very helpful when it comes to deciding which cows to sell, given the expected seasonal conditions on your property. Foetal aging allows you to tighten your calving pattern, and it also allows you to identify your intercalving intervals, which is an important measure of fertility. Foetal aging allows you to identify your most fertile heifers, and it also gives you an opportunity to identify any production losses that may be occurring because of disease. There is no point foetal aging unless you have good infrastructure that allows you to segregate your cows. It is also helpful to have good planning and good data collection and management, which allows you to make the decisions you need. Foetal aging provides you with more information than just pregnant or empty. It allows you to forward plan and gives you options.
There's not much point in segregating on foetal age if you haven't got stock-proof paddocks. So that's one of the first things before it's even worthwhile, unless you're just going to cull the cows on foetal age. You need a basic crush set up with a kick gate, a decent vet crush, because it's not acceptable anymore to take risks in a cattle yard. If there's segregation failure, you need to have kept records so that you can redraft. Most yards these days have got some sort of scales that can have alerts. We use the NLS system or the RFID system pretty heavily for all our record keeping, and all the cattle are recorded against their foetal age so that if the worst happens and two mobs get boxed, we can draft up the crush. Failing that, a simple tag list is slower but just as effective. If I had to name one benefit from foetal aging, that really stands out in our environment out here. It's the ability to do targeted early weaning when the wet season fails. It's a lot more effective to feed a cow and a calf separately than a cow raising a calf. And it increases the chance of that cow getting back in calf, greatly increases the chance of her staying alive. It saves money and is more effective in the outcome. Nobody out here in the 80s did restricted joining, and the one thing that got them adopting that was saying, you just leave the bulls in and foetal age back to that, and you can join over 6 months if you like, but you've got 3 months in one group and 3 months in the other group, no matter how tough the environment is. It just helps with the management, and you've lost nothing. The bulls are still in, you're just identifying them and segregating them. If there were two golden nuggets, that'd be not pulling the bulls out and being able to early wean. The segregation gives you the early weaning capability, and the foetal aging gives you the ability to leave the bulls in and still have a restricted joining period, which is big for a commercial operation.
For help or advice on incorporating foetal aging into your management system, contact your local extension officer or visit the Future Beef website.